In today's video, we dive into one of the most surprising and powerful returns in modern British air defence history. The Thunderbird 2027, a completely reimagined surface-to-air missile system, has finally been revealed, and it looks nothing like its Cold War ancestor. Instead, this modern Thunderbird is designed to defend the United Kingdom and its allies against the threats of the 2020s and beyond, including hypersonic glide vehicles, stealth drones, hostile cruise missiles, and high-performance aircraft. What you're about to see is the rebirth of a British legend, engineered for a completely new battlefield. The Thunderbird 2027 has been developed with one main goal in mind, giving UK ground forces a long-range, mobile, and highly accurate anti-air shield that can keep up with rapid deployment units. The original Thunderbird missile of the 1950s was massive, static, and limited by the technology of its era. But this 2027 version is compact, fast-reacting, digitally guided, and completely network-enabled. Instead of being tied to a fixed launcher, the new Thunderbird is mounted on an 8x8 high-mobility British military vehicle, capable of off-road movement, rapid relocation, and firing within minutes of arriving at a new position. This upgrade alone massively increases survivability in modern combat, where counter-battery radar and drone surveillance make static defenses incredibly vulnerable. One of the most exciting features is the missile itself. The Thunderbird 2027 uses a dual-pulse solid rocket motor, giving it not only high initial acceleration but also sustained maneuverability during the mid-course and terminal phases. The missile can make extremely sharp directional changes thanks to its vectoring nozzle technology. This means it can chase down targets performing violent evasive maneuvers at high speed. Early reports suggest a maximum range of around 110 km and an interception altitude of up to 25 km, bringing it close to the capability of major global systems, while still being fully British designed and tailored for UK and NATO integration. Guidance has also taken a huge leap forward. Instead of relying on a single method such as radar beam riding, the Thunderbird 2027 uses a full tri-mode seeker combining active radar, passive radar, and infrared homing. This means the missile can track targets in heavy electronic warfare environments and can continue pursuing even if the enemy tries to jam the signal. The system can lock onto low observable aircraft, stealth drones, and even some classes of hypersonic weapons by predicting their flight path with real-time data fed from multiple sensors across the networked battlespace. Speaking of sensors, the new fire control radar is said to be one of the most advanced ever fitted to a British ground unit. It uses AESA radar panels capable of detecting extremely small targets, including micro-drones and loitering munitions, which have become major threats on the modern battlefield. This radar system can track more than 400 targets simultaneously and prioritize the most dangerous ones using an artificial intelligence-assisted threat evaluation system. This allows commanders to react faster than ever before, reducing human workload and increasing accuracy during high-intensity engagements. Another major improvement is the launcher's ability to carry multiple missile types. The primary long-range Thunderbird 2027 missile is the star of the system, but the launcher can also fire smaller point defense missiles such as LMM Martlet or a future UK short-range interceptor. This layered approach gives frontline units the flexibility to defeat everything from large fighter jets to cheap drone swarms without wasting an expensive long-range interceptor. Mobility is key, and the new launcher vehicle has been designed with a low signature profile. It has infrared suppression, radar absorbent shaping, and digital camouflage. This makes it far harder for enemy reconnaissance drones to identify and target. The system is also fully electric compatible, meaning it can operate silently on battery power for short periods, reducing the chances of detection from acoustic sensors. The command and control cabin is completely digital, featuring multi-screen layouts, touch-based controls, and an encrypted battlefield communication suite. Operators can coordinate launches with Royal Air Force early warning aircraft, naval destroyers equipped with Type 45 radars, and even satellites. This high level of integration allows the Thunderbird 2027 to fight as part of a huge digital defense network, covering airspace far beyond its physical location. One of the most impressive aspects is how quickly the system can deploy. From the moment the crew arrives at a location, the launcher can be ready to fire in under 3 minutes. After firing, it can be on the move again almost instantly, preventing counter-fire from targeting its position. This shoot-and-scoot capability is vital in modern warfare, where stationary units do not survive for long. The Thunderbird 2027 is widely expected to replace some older UK systems and support allies who need strong, reliable, NATO-compatible air defence. With its long range, incredible accuracy, advanced seeker technology, and strong mobility platform, this missile system could become one of the strongest ground-based air defence solutions in Europe. As we move deeper into the 2020s, threats are evolving rapidly. Drones, stealth aircraft, and fast missiles are becoming more common every year. The United Kingdom's answer is clear: a modernized, extremely capable, fully networked system that carries the Thunderbird name into the future. This is not just a missile, it's a complete defensive ecosystem designed to protect troops, vehicles, bases, and cities against almost any airborne threat. And with the 2027 reveal, the world has now witnessed a new era of British missile technology.